Assalamualaikum everyone, Tech Love from Mr. TechFox. Today, I'll guide you on how to completely clear all cache and junk files from Windows 10 and 11 in a step-by-step manner. If this video helps you, please support me by subscribing to my channel. Your one subscribe motivates me to create more helpful content for you. Let's dive right in. So we're gonna follow the step one. First of all, we are gonna clear temporary files using the run dialog. So normally you have to press on your keyboard Windows key plus R. So I'm gonna press Windows key plus R here, and it will open the run window. And in this dialog box, you have to type temp. So I'm gonna type here temp, T-E-M-P, and after then press enter. And you have to give it a permission, so click on continue, and it will open all of the temporary files. Normally you have to select all of the files by pressing on your keyboard Ctrl plus A, and then you have to delete them. Right click on your mouse and select delete and press continue. And if you see again and again this type of pop-up windows, then you have to check this box and click on escape. And now we are gonna open run dialog box again. So normally we are gonna press again Windows key plus R button. And now we have to type here modulus, I mean percentage sign, temp, and percentage again. Press enter again, and this opens another folder containing temporary files. We have to select all of them now, and we have to delete them again. And if you see some of the files can be deleted, normally check this box and select escape. Lastly, open the run dialog box one more time by pressing Windows key plus R, and here you have to type prefetch. So I'm gonna type here P-R-E-F-E-T-C-H, prefetch, and press enter. Give the permission by clicking on the continue button, and delete all of the files in this folder too. So I'm gonna click Ctrl plus A to select all of the files, and I'm gonna right click on my mouse and selecting delete. And if you see this kind of pop-up, normally select escape. Alright. And now we are gonna follow the step 2, and we'll use the built-in disk cleanup tool. So normally we have to search on our startup disk cleanup tool. So I'm gonna search here disk cleanup, and you have to press enter, and you will see a pop-up like this. Normally select the drive where you have installed your Windows. So this is defaultly C drive. Normally click on OK, and you will see an interface like this. Normally you have to select temporary internet files, then recycle bins, temporary files, and you can also select thumbnails, and normally click on OK button. These are gonna delete unnecessary files. Normally click on continue if you see this kind of interface, and it will take some time to delete the unnecessary files. After then, we are gonna clean in a deeper way. So normally we have to search again here disk cleanup tool, press enter, again C drive, and press OK, and choose clean up system files. Click again OK, and it will calculate all of the unnecessary files of your systems. And from here, you can choose whatever you wanna delete. Here you will get Windows update log files, downloaded program files, temporary internet files, and you will also get unnecessary Windows update files. You can also delete them by checking the box. So I'm gonna press OK. Delete files. And this process will clean up all of the unnecessary files from your desktop. Alright, now we are gonna move into step 3. We are gonna clear all of the browser cache from our PC. So normally we are gonna clear the Chrome browser's cache. So I'm gonna open the Chrome browser from my desktop. And normally we have to click on the top right corner's 3-dot icon. And from here, we have to go to settings. So normally we have to choose privacy and security. And here we have to choose delete browsing data. And from here, check cached images and files and cookies and other site data. And choose the drop-down menu all time. And click on delete button. Now we are gonna clear the cache of Microsoft Edge browser. So normally we have to open the browser. I'm gonna search it on the start menu. Edge. Open it. And normally you have to click on the three dots in the top right corner. And here you have to go to settings. Again, privacy search and services. Normally click on this, choose what to clear. And here you have to choose from the drop-down menu all time and select clear now. And now we are gonna do it for Firefox browser. Normally open your Firefox browser. And from here, click on the three-dot bar and go to privacy and security settings. So normally we are gonna navigate into settings, privacy and security. And here we are gonna delete all of the unnecessary files. And from here, you have to choose clear data. And from the drop-down menu, choose everything. And you can also delete all of the history of your browser. And you can also check this size setting options. It will reset all of the settings of your browser. And normally click on clear. And that's it. Now we are gonna move into step 4. We are gonna delete unnecessary system files. So normally we have to open our settings. So we can access our settings by normally pressing Windows key plus I button, or you can open it from the startup menu by searching settings or clicking on the gear icon. And after that, we have to go to system, and here we have to find out storage, and from here we have to find temporary files. So normally click on these temporary files. And here, Windows will scan for temporary files, including delivery optimization files, previous Windows installations, and more. Now, select the categories of files you want to delete, and now you have to click on Remove Files. And now, we are gonna move into step 5. We are gonna enable and configure storage settings. So normally, we have to open our settings. So normally we are going to click on this startup menu and selecting the gear icon of settings. And here we have to go on system, storage. And now we have to click on this configure storage settings. So here you can enable options like automatically delete temporary files and delete files in the recycle bin after 30 days. You can configure this setting by your own choice. You can choose it every month, and you can check this box, and you can choose this 30 days and set it never, because we don't want to lose our data from downloads folder. Alright, or you can customize these settings by your own choice. Alright, and now we are gonna remove all restore points. So normally we have to right click on this PC. Normally we have to open the file manager first. This is. And right click on it. Select properties. And from here, choose system protection. And here you will see a pop-up window. And select your system drive. It's normally C drive. And click on configure. And normally, if you wanna delete all of the previous restore points, click on delete button. And click on continue button. It will delete all of the old restore points. It will free up your disk space. And finally, we are gonna go to step 7. We are gonna use command prompt for additional cleaning. Normally, we have to open our command prompt. So we are gonna click on this startup menu. And we have to type here CMD and right click on it. And select run as administrator. Press yes. And here you have to type it will open advanced disk cleanup settings. Select all of the options that you want to delete and press an OK button. And that's it. By following these steps, you can effectively clear all cache and junk files from your Windows 11 or Windows 10 PC. I hope this solves your problem and keeps your system running smoothly. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Mr. TechFox. Your support keeps me motivated to bring you more helpful guides. See you in the next video. Till then, Allah Hafiz.